The day after Francis became Pope, he was shown his new official residence. He strolled from room to room and met the staff. In a city where spacious homes are hard to come by, the papal apartment is downright palatial, with more than a dozen rooms and a stunning view. But according to reports in the Italian press, he said it was too big, and that it could accommodate 300 people. And now it's official. He's not moving in. Instead, he prefers to stay in room 201, a modest suite at the Casa Santa Marta, the residence where cardinals stayed during the conclave. The furnishings are relatively austere, though hardly monastic. The sitting room does, however, have a mini bar. Tourist Juan Sarmiento, a fellow Argentinian, is impressed.
I think it's an excellent notice that the Pope is close to the people and not close to the gold and the rich things.
German Christina Baer has a more practical interpretation.
I think it's the climate because it's very hot in this building. In summer, the sun comes from the south directly on this flat, and I think it will be very warm there.
Officials at the Holy See are cautioning, don't jump to conclusions.
The Vatican press office has put out a notice saying that they want journalists to avoid using language such as Pope abandons apostolic palace or Pope turns back on wealth of papal apartments, that he simply wants to be in the Vatican residence where he can be close to people and take advantage of the services available there.
He's chosen to ride the bus when he could have taken his official chauffeur-driven car and paid his own hotel bill after becoming Pope. And he's wearing sensible black shoes, not the red ones, in which he's walking away from the trappings of power, if not power itself. Ben Wiedemann, CNN, Rome.